Hello everyone, my name is Kelly. Today I'm going to introduce how we are using architecture. So everybody knows that we are using many fields such as education, sports, entertainment, manufacture, and medical professions. But we can easily build a world within a little device. When you play a game, you feel more excited, or when you have the medical treatment, it will reduce your pain. However, do you know that VR could also be used in architecture, and how could it be used? An architecture is a three-dimensional object, so it is really hard to imagine how it looks like before it built. You can just see some pictures provided by the architects and just rely on them. If you are not satisfied with the finished building, you have no method to alter it. It is really horrible, isn't it? Many architects are also aware that one of the great challenges they face is how to effectively communicate the design of the architecture to customers, developers, and investors. A large number of drawings and complex construction procedures make it difficult to present the architectural views. In addition, how to improve the efficiency of communication is the key to success. But now you have another choice. VR is gradually used in architecture. Traditional two-dimensional drawings and three-dimensional models can only create realistic three-dimensional renderings. However, with the VR headset, it can help the user walk through the details. This is actually the ideal tool for architects to create a comprehensive visual model. With the VR, customer can see the outlook of the building and the indoor decoration. Besides, they could change the part that do not meet their vision. In this way, architects can understand their dissatisfaction immediately. This is very important. VR can improve the efficiency of communication and reduce the rework time. However, VR also has some shortcomings when using in architecture. The main drawback is the expense. The company should not only care about the price of the devices and also should hire the technician who know how to use a VR device. So many companies think that spending lots of money in it isn't a wise choice. And the VR need lots of techniques too. So the company should spend lots of time in it in order to get a really successful VR architecture. With the advantages and disadvantages discussing above, I interview a person who majors in architecture. She would tell us her experience of using VR and the real application to architecture.
请问你是哪个大学，然后哪个科系的学生？
是朝阳建筑的，然后对，建筑系，然后室内设计组。
好。请问你有没有玩过 VR 或用过 VR 的经验？
有，在学校的图书馆六楼，它是一个团体阅览室，然后。阅览室里面有，它有分好几间，然后其中有几间是那个 AR 跟 VR 的应用。
那请问一下，你有没有在做你们科系的作业的时候，有没有遇到什么，比如说空间啊，或者什么这方面的困难？
我们最常做的其实就是画图。建模，然后做模型。那其实最大的困难其实不在于做模型，那其实只要花费一些时间，它就可以有一些成果。那其实最大的困难是在图面表现的时候，就是其实有很大一个部分，不只是平面，或是你转成三视图，甚至是等角图，还有透视图的时候，可以很。清楚的表达的，所以我们通常会再去建模，从 SketchUp 或是其他软体建成一个立体的模型，然后从里面去截图，截取角度，然后去选图之后， 去更明显的表达那些我们想要表达的情境，可能走在这个廊道里面他会有什么感受，那他带给那个通过的人会有什么心灵上的感觉，这样。其实最大的困难不在于设计，而是在于如何去阐述你的设计，让别人也可以很清楚的了解。
好，那请问一下，就是从你刚刚讲的那些困难里面，你觉得有没有办法从 VR 里面找到可能相对的解决办法？
有，其实在系上他们有添购一些器材，就是 AR 跟 VR 方面的器材。那之前有看过助教跟老师他们拍摄使用的影片，就是他们其实是很真实的把我们建好的模然后转成在 VR 里面的它的环境，然后它有控制器，然后在行走之间可以去调整每个空间可能这个墙面的材质，就是除了在跟你的业主沟通、使用者沟通的时候，他们可以更亲临感受，或是亲临现场，甚至是直接的去改变，然后去调整到他们自己真正想要的样子，而不是在图面上纸上谈兵的感觉。
所以它就可以更真实的呈现出你们设计的那种空间感。
对。
那请问你觉得就是你就是使用 VR 会有什么样的缺点吗？像是可能是经费方面啊，你觉得有没有办法每个人都拥有，可能每个建筑师都拥有一台，或者是一整个设计团队拥有一台，你觉得这会不会很困难？
我觉得其实一个建案可能对一个公司来讲它是一个很庞大的经济来源，那如果可以借由这个工具然后去增进业主跟设计者之间的沟通的话，我觉得它是一个很好的工具。不过一般人刻板印象来讲会觉得好像很贵，然后好像很复杂，可能会因为需要 VR 增加一个 VR 的这个工具，那可能还要再多聘请一个这个技术方面的人员，那这个部分上可能会比较昂贵一点。
那你觉得有就是可能在做出一个 VR 然后的建筑类似模型之类这样，你觉得里面会不会用到很多不关于你们就是可能科系方面的才能吗？你会觉得很难吗？
我觉得好像会比，因为我熟知的软体 3D 软体大概就是 SketchUp， 我希望如果之后可以应用在 VR 上的话，我希望 VR 写这些空间的软体上会可以更简易一点，就比如说像 SketchUp 它是直接去 Google 就可以下载试用版，那它的操作界面是很简易的，那希望 VR 也可以这么轻易的操作，这样子会更普及，然后会带来给人们更多的方便，这样子。
因为 VR 里面可能不只有，
对，因为它不只
有软体啊，或者是什么别的才能的人才有办法完成这一整个 VR 的建筑，是吗？
对，
嗯，
就感觉就好像不是只是建模，因为好像要写一点软体，那软体可能对如果是建筑者来讲或是设计者来讲，感觉好像是不太擅长，就是领域不一样。
my brief introduction of VR using in architecture. Hope that in the future, VR could be more popular and also bring lots of convenience to our society. Thanks for watching.